Hi guys, and welcome to another Divi video. This is Jamie from System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Today we're using the great Divi Plus plugin from Divi Extended here, and we've put together all these cool things very quickly just to test it out. Today I'm going to show you how to use a pop-up modal, and this is a feature that's been missing from Divi, and this adds that functionality for you. A modal is when you click on something and it pops up a separate page for you or a separate item. So if I click on this button right here, it pops up this little modal thing. You can put in whatever content you want. Now I've just got a simple text in here at the moment. If I close this down, if I click on this other one over here, it's actually going to pop up something from my library, and you can pop up all full layouts. You can pop up just about anything you want to. So I'm going to go ahead and click on it. There it is. It's popped it up, and we've got a little image accordion in there and a little blurb module. You can put in anything you want, and this is just popping it up from my library. Like I say, this feature has been missing from Divi, and it gets requested quite a lot. So let's get started. First thing I'm going to do is enable the Visual Builder. Once enabled, let's go down to where we want to work. And I'll simply delete this button and we'll start again. Okay, so I'm going to hit the little dark button to add a new module here. I want to go down a bit, and here we are. Anything with DP in front of it is the Divi Plus ones, and you get a lot of new modules included with it. I'm looking for the DP modal. There it is right there. So I'm going to click on that. And here we go. And it's warning us we want to give it a unique ID. Well, I've got one there already. It's got an ID of 1. So let's give this an ID of 3. Now, what do we want to trigger it on? An element? Or we can trigger it on page load. And that's great for making pop-ups, cookie consent forms and what have you. Or exit intent, which means when they're going up to click out of the page. I'm going to go ahead and do it on an element today. I'll use a button for it. You can use an image, an icon, text, whatever you want. But I'm going to use a button today. Or let's say pop-up modal. Pop-up modal. You can close it by hitting the escape key if you turn that to on. I'm happy to have just an X there, but that's a nice little feature. Now you can style. You can choose to show your model header, modal title, and close icon here. I've got those all to yes. Put in whatever you want for the header. Inside the modal body, there's all kind of different contents. I'll just put a bit of text in at first, but a great feature of this is you can add images, videos, so you can have a pop-up video, which is another great feature, or you can add something from your library, and I'll do that in a second, but let's just start with a bit of text. I've got lipsum.com open here, so let's put a bit of dummy text in there. And we'll pop it in here. And like any other text module, you can add media, you can link things, you can align things. And this is the footer of the modal when it pops up. If you don't want to show it, turn that to off. And it'll put a little button in there that says close. You can write whatever you want. Background wise, I'm going to leave mine just a plain white background. We've got the trigger element background, which is the button that we're going to have. The overlay is actually what it does when it pops up to the site here. So let's put a color in there. We'll put a black, but let's not make it fairly opaque so it's fairly see-through. Modal background, I'm just going to leave that as white for convenience. Modal header background, if you want to give it a different color, you can. Let's just make it blue for fun, but we'll have to change our text so we can see there. Body background, again, I'm going to leave that as white. Footer background, let's make that black, but we'll have to change the text in there as well. Okay, let's pop over to our design. Alignment, trigger element alignment. I'm going to pop mine in the middle. As you can see, it's right there. trigger button, you can use custom styles and style it like any other Divi button. I'm going to leave mine just like that, which is the generic Divi version at the moment. But if you want to style it, go ahead and go in there. Trigger text, you can change the font, everything here. I'm happy to leave mine just as it is. It's got all the sort of text styling that you could need there. Title text, we need to change this color because I think we made the title or the header blue, didn't we? So let's make the text white, pop them in the middle, make it semi-bold. Body text, I'm going to leave just as it is. Close icon, that's going to be in the top. So let's make that one red, I guess. Close button at the bottom. Again, you can style it however you want. I'm going to leave mine just as the generic. And I'm going to put it on the right hand side. Not going to use any box shadow or a border. Model sizing or modal sizing and alignment. Center's fine for me. You can have it top right, bottom left, etc., etc. I'm just going to leave mine in the center there. You can give it a fixed width if you want to, and a fixed height if you want to. I'm going to leave mine just on auto. Sizing, spacing, transform, animation. Those are all good. So let's see what we've actually got. So let's save this one. There's our little one we're working on at the moment. Let's save our page changes here. Save draft or publish if you're ready. And exit the visual builder. And we'll go down. There it is. Roll it down just a little bit. There we go. We've got our little pop-up. There's that opaque background color that I put in there. It's just a plain white background. There's our little footer. There's our little close modal button. You don't have to have that as well. And like I say, you can put anything in you want. I'll show you another great feature now, is that you can load anything from your library. For instance, we could save this gallery and put that in there if you want to. I haven't got that, but I have got a few things saved in my library. So let's enable the Visual Builder. And let's go down to where we were working. Go back into our module here. What I've actually got, I've got a row that's got this image carousel in it and also a blurb underneath, and I'll add that from my library. So let's go in here, back into our pop-up, into our modal body, and instead of text this time, I'm going to say Divi library layout, and it'll show us everything that's in our library here. So I know I've got that little image carousel there. Let's pop that one in there. And you can choose anything from your library. You can save sections, rows, or individual modules themselves. And this is a great feature. And I'll be doing another feature about short codes, which is another great way of doing it with the Divi Plus. So let's save our changes. And save the page changes. Let's exit now. And go on down to where we were working. Now let's click on this and it'll pop up that whole section. There we go, there's that whole section we just put in there from our library. Like I say, it's just a blurb module and this little image accordion here. And that is a really, really handy feature. We'll close him up now. So there you have it, guys. That's how to create a pop-up modal using the fantastic Divi Plus plugin from Divi Extended. I hope you've enjoyed this today and found it useful. If you have, please give it a thumbs up, ring the bell, comment, share, and subscribe to the YouTube channel. Once again, this has been Jamie from System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.